Welcome RPA Champions, I am the RPA Champion and in today's video we are going to be looking at how to share to multiple Facebook groups at the same time, and we're going to be doing this in 5 steps. These steps are going to be really easy, and to do this we are going to be using Microsoft Power Automate. It's a technology that requires you to know zero code. You don't have to be a developer or a trained expert to do this kind of automation. The technology is also completely free. It is available from Microsoft. You can download it at any time. We're going to see that later on in the video. We are going to be doing this because Facebook has decided to take away the ability for people to share to different Facebook groups. Now, there has been many different discussions and questions raised. Why has Facebook decided to do this? There is different answers, but the fact remains that this is not available anymore, so a lot of time has to be put into uploading your message to different Facebook groups. Let's solve this matter with automation. Now, step one is going to be to download and install Power Automate Desktop. There is nothing simpler to do than install Power Automate Desktop, especially because it is provided by Microsoft. It is going to be interesting to see if it's going to be available in Windows 11. Step two is to create a list in Excel that is going to contain the URL to the different Facebook groups that we want to visit. And also in a second column, we are going to have the message that we're going to post to the different groups. Now let's jump into Power Automate and let's create our first process. We're going to be creating a new process and starting from a blank canvas. The first action that we are going to do is we are going to open the Excel sheet, because the first things that we need to do is get all of that Excel information or all of those URL and messages and put them inside of Power Automate so that we can work with it. The next step that we have to do is read a range of cells in Excel. Now, this is going to allow us to get all of the information that is available inside of our Excel sheet and put it inside of a variable so that we can do different things with this information. We could be also using get first free row and first free column, but we are going to make this simpler and we're just going to hard code the different values from our range of cells. The values are going to be stored in a variable, the Excel variable that is produced automatically, and all of the data is going to be there. Now, the last step that we need to do is close our Excel sheet so that we don't use too much memory while we are testing our process. Now, let's run this and see if the variable that we have created is going to get filled out with the different URLs and messages. So once we open it, we see that we have everything. Now let's move on to step three. And in this step, we need to get the different web elements that we are going to be using and interacting with. Now we are going to be using Google Chrome. So let's navigate to the Facebook group and let's hit the record button and record and spy the different elements that we are going to be recording and using inside of our process. Now, what we need to spy is we need to spy the input field. Once the input field is clicked, a pop-up appears. Now we need to spy the text inside of this pop-up. There is different ways that we could do this. There is also different selectors that appear and that could get highlighted. So what I suggest to you is just to try it out a few times until you get the right selector. You could also integrate different selectors and then add that same value to each one of those selectors. We will see that a little bit later. Once we have recorded the different actions, the actions will be automatically be created and put inside of our flow so that we can fine-tune them and use them immediately inside of our process. Now, I am going to slow down the process a little bit just to make sure that all of the actions can be spied and seen correctly once a new page of Facebook is opened. Why am I doing this? Is because Facebook uses quite complex selectors. So it would be good practice to test your selectors once you web record or spy the different elements. In this case, everything seems to be working. Therefore, I can move on with the next actions. Now, before I move on with the next actions, it would be also good practice to rename all of the different elements that I have created right now using the recording. This will allow me to keep things tidy and also not lose track of the different elements that are going to be put inside of Power Automate as we build our process. Let's now move on to the following step, and this is going to be step four. And in this step, we are going to be adding a loop. We need to add a for each loop to our process. Now there is different kinds of loops. We could also use a simple loop, but it will be easier to use a for each loop because the for each loop is going to allow us to cycle through each one of the rows available in our Excel variable. What do I mean by that? I mean that we have extracted the Excel data and put it inside of the Excel variable. Now we're going to create our loop that is going to iterate or cycle through all of the different data that is inside of that variable. It will produce as an output a variable that is called current item that we could use. We are going to also move all of our different steps inside of our process. We're going to move all of those steps inside of the loop. Now, this will allow all of the different steps to be executed for as many times as the rows inside of the Excel sheet. For the last and final step, step 5, we're going to be putting this all together. I have added in this step a few little modifications and changes to the process just to make it not break and make it work without a glitch. Now, I'm going to go through all the different steps and show them to you so that you can copy and repeat what I have done here. Now, the first step is just launching the Excel sheet. It is going to connect to the file and it's going to produce a variable that is going to be referencing our Excel sheet. In the next step, we are going to be calling that variable that we have created, and I have hard-coded the value for the range that we want to select. Now, we are going to select this range from the Excel sheet that is going to contain our comment and is going to contain also the URL to the URL. And we are also going to store this inside of a variable. After that, we are going to use an increment. We're going to increment a variable and close the Excel sheet. Now, it's important to close the Excel sheet to save the memory while we are running this process and also while we are testing. The next thing we are doing is we are opening the loop, or we are creating a loop, and we're navigating to the different pages. Now, the first thing is that we have inside of our loop is the navigate action that is going to navigate to the first row and first column, or column 0, inside of our Excel sheet. I have decided to use not the current item that is produced inside of the loop, but I have used the Excel sheet and I have created the increment variable so that I can increment from row 1 until row 2, row 3, row 4, and so forth, as our loop is going through all of the different current items inside of the Excel sheet. Now, for all of the different web elements, I have added an error or an exception to the error. So if there is an error, or if it doesn't, if it cannot find it, it is just going to move to the next step inside of our process. Now, I have added this only to all of the web elements because those are the only elements that could potentially fail inside of this process. And if they fail, probably all of the subsequent web elements would fail as well. Therefore, I have added the same thing on all of the different web elements. So if they all fail, the process is just going to go through all of them and it is going to the next case. I have also added a few weights here and there, a wait of 2 seconds and a wait of 7 seconds. The wait are also important because it will allow the application to respond differently in different situations. So when you're clicking on a button, it is going to give the application some time, or give Facebook some time to respond properly. We are also going to be using an element that was not web recorded. So I have used the send keys element to send the text inside of the post field on Facebook. So the easiest way to do this, is instead of inputting inside of an input field, would be to send the hardware text keys. So that's what I'm doing from the Excel sheet. I'm accessing column B. Therefore, I have made it so that every different URL can have a different message that you could post it to, so that you don't have to post the same message to every single Facebook group. So we are using the increment variable, and we are looping through the different rows and accessing the message that is related to the row that we are in. Now, after that, once we have sent the keys, we are going to post our message. And again, just like on the previous one, I have added an exception handling on this, or a condition that is just going to send it to the next step. Now, the final step is to increment the variable. Therefore, that means that we're going to go into the following row inside of our Excel sheet. So from row 1, we're going to go to row 2, and we are going to be able to navigate to the next link and also get the next message as well. So once we have done that, we can close our browser and repeat the whole process again. And this is our process in a nutshell. It does this for as many times, as there are rows inside of the Excel sheet. It is going to go to every single Excel sheet row and it's going to post that message, saving us time for doing it ourselves. So until Facebook brings that feature, we can use this. Now, RPA champions, I hope that you have enjoyed this video. I hope that you're enjoying your journey in automation. As a final reminder, remember, subscribe to the RPA champion, and I will see you in the next video.